Marriage and togetherness in love. Master or sheikh is not a person. He is both form and formless. He bridges the two aspects. One is visible and one the other which is not visible. That is a state of awareness. If you see the reflection of the sun in the mirror, that means you are seeing the reflection that something is there. But the reflection means that there has to be the original. Otherwise, there cannot be the image that you are seeing, you are connected with. Then Master continues to send light, the seeds of awareness to each one of us. But because we are engrossed in the sense objects and we continue to dwell in the realm of sense organs, objects and beings, or in simple words, in the material world, the light that reaches us becomes very dull and dim. It is like you are watching a television show. The station that you are connected continues to send its programs. But if there is any problem in your connectivity or in the antenna, then the images will come out dull and distorted. The pictures may be hazy because there is an outside interference. Similarly, when the interference comes into us from the material worlds, your constant dwelling amidst the sense organs and sense objects and beings, the light you receive will be distorted and dim. For some people, the picture of on the television show will be clear, and for others, the picture will be hazy. When our image is clear, the clarity or the distortion of the image depends on the quality of the receiver. We are all transmitting stations, transmitting equipment. If the instrument is in proper order, we can receive the feeblest of vibrations wherever we are. A sheikh or the spiritual master tries to reach the seeker with the light that he is, the awareness that he is. The master or sheikh to whom you are connected tries to reach out to you to share that presence, that awareness that God has given him. But we are not using the power that is given to us to keep ourselves, our antennas in order. Spirituality, when it comes, it is same for all of us. God has made each one of us in the same way. It is not that my spiritual nature will be different from that of you or any other person. There would be no discrimination. If that is the case, then there would be injustice. And also it is often said, because of this veil that has been created because of constant dwelling in sense objects through the instruments of sense organs, that we continue to say that we love God, but we cannot love His creation. What is the sense of saying that you love God but you do not love His creation? That means there is the light that is coming is dull and dim, and you have not understood the essence. You cannot love God directly, but you can love God through His creation. Marriage gives you one of the greatest opportunity to love your spouse in its totality, and through that you reach to the ultimate. That love bridges you with that which is with totality for God. But there comes a fear. If you go too much into pleasures, that marriage is bound to bring, you may be entering into the forbidden territory of pain. It is always there. And it is the pain that gives birth to pleasure. You have to start with pain if it comes. And if you are open to pain, and if you want sometimes to cry, then there is no harm. Where else will you cry if you cannot cry before your spouse? Forget all nonsense that man cannot cry, that has been taught. If a man never cries, he is not a man. Either he is inhuman or he is superhuman. But one thing is certain, he is not man. Sometimes crying is important. It helps to clear the suppressed emotions. This is why crying has been used as one of the meditation, but it has the other side of this coin. Crying and laughter, they go together. When you cry, it ultimately leads to laughter. And when you laugh, it ultimately leads to crying. It clears the emotions. Sometimes it is good to use it as a device. And meditatively use crying as a tool. Cry sometimes, share your sorrows and your sadness. Weep like a child in totality. Crying will clear many suppressed emotions of which you have become unaware. It is therapeutic. And the same I am saying to your spouse. She has to do the same. And by you will see that a great intimacy begins to arise. Crying and laughter are two sides of the coin, and together they form a meditation, a technique of meditation. Crying will clear many suppressed emotions. It is therapeutic. And laughter hammers the solar plexus. I am saying the same to your spouse. She has to do the same, and by you will find that there is a great intimacy arisen which has nothing to do with the society, and with that intimacy much more happiness will begin to come. You will explode into happiness, and that will ultimately lead you to the state of bliss. But you have to begin with pain. Always remember that everything has to begin in pain. Meditate together. Open your hearts as they are. Sometimes wrong, sometimes rotten. Other times not even worth showing to anyone. Yet still, you have to gather courage to show it to your beloved. In this way, you will also help your spouse to show everything. And when all the cards are open, you are not even holding a trump card. A new kind of intimacy arises on its own accord. And that is the essence that each spouse tries to seek in this male-female relation. For me, intimacy implies, before you I will be totally nude. I will not hide anything. That is what intimacy is all about. Intimacy is not a biological nudeness. It is a psychological neatness that you do not hide anything. It is when you are in the room, I will be as if I am alone. Your presence will not make me repress something. Your presence will not make me change and show something else which is not there. I will be as natural as I am in my loneliness or in my washroom when I am alone. Then there is an intimacy. There is a risk in it. One never knows what will come out of it. But one thing can be said certainly, whatever comes out is beautiful. If out of that intimacy separation comes, it will be beautiful. More beautiful than this so-called marriage. If marriage comes out of it, it will be tremendously beautiful and something which you have not imagined or experienced at all. If there is existing relationship, it will continue its journey for fruition. And this, then you will realize that when it is said that I love God, but you cannot love Him directly because God is formless. And unless you attain to the state of formless, you cannot attain to that intimacy. But you can attain to intimacy with the form. You are a form and your spouse is also a form. But the two things of different dimensions, different qualities cannot merge into one another. First, you have to attain to that state of formlessness within you. Then different kind of love arises in you. It is not love as you know. Instead, it becomes devotion for the cause of one another. Devotion is the union of formless to formless. You have sought the formless within you, that which is beyond the body. Formless is that which is not affected by the body, mind or intellect. Instead, it is the union of three. And not only the union, instead, something beyond the three. That beyondness is the formlessness. And that is the ultimate love when it becomes devotion. Love is the only scripture that God wrote. Indeed, love is the only scripture that is it is unseen but to realize truth. God gave you this scripture as unseen but to realize truth. You can experience the traces of it in a state of intimacy. Through the male-female intimacy, you will learn how to be intimate, devoted to your Sheikh. And through that, you can one day be connected to the formlessness that God is. And one thing that God did is that He hid the entire scripture deep within you. You are the seed of love. And when you are the seed, one day when the seed sprouts, you become the tree of love. And again one day when the tree brings myriad blossoms, there are flowers and fruits as well. The day you are capable to discover the seeds of this scripture deep within you, your spiritual journey begins. It does not matter whether it begins, whether you discover the seed within you through your male-female relation, because this is one of the easiest ways to discover that seed within you. By nature, man seeks God all around, and misses him deep within. Deep within the spouse, deep within himself. Even when his search somehow begins within, he finds he is unable to decipher all that is written in this scripture. Nothing seems to be written, yet still everything is written. But it is written in a different language. You have to learn the art of hearing the unheard and seeing the unseen. I reveal to you a few pages through this eternal scripture love that God has hidden in you. That is why not only I love you, love is my message. I thank you for showing that to me, because it is through you. You become the window through which I see the myriad miracles of the existence. Love is the texture that has given the form and shape to my being. Love is the communion. It is oneness. It is harmony both within and without. It is bliss. Let it be your quality too. Love is my color and climate. Love is the only religion that I gave for you. All else is just unnecessary and therefore it can be discarded. All else is nothing but dreams, a mental game. Love is the only substantial thing in life. All else is illusion. Let love grow in you, and then one day you will hear the silent footsteps when I approach you. I will be growing in my own accord. If you miss love, you will miss me and all. Then life will become misery and despair. In a most sublime and sacred way, this scripture reveals this secret. There is no other way to God without love, says this scripture. There is nothing more sublime than love. God can be forgotten but not love. If love is remembered, God will happen as a consequence. It always happens as a consequence. God is the fragrance of love and nothing else. In fact, there is no God. Instead, there is only godliness. There is no person like God sitting anywhere. When I say there is divineness, I mean whatsoever is full of God, is full of love. Entire creation is full of godliness. Only you need eyes to see it. The green of the trees, the red of the flowers, the golden glow of the rising sun, all are embodiment of love and the divine. A crow crying, a bird on the wings, a child giggling, dog barking, all is divine. Nothing else exists. The moment you feel this, love attains a new meaning. Love then will give birth to you. The moment love gives birth to you, you are a totally different person. Then you can remember the beautiful lines that one of the scriptures, Hindu scripture, Ishopanishad, begins. To say that it is a Hindu scripture is erroneous. Truth is never Hindu, Muslim, or anything else. It is cosmic. It begins, the entire cosmos is permeated by ever-expanding consciousness or Isa. Referring, the word Isa refers to God. It is your realization now, experience of that love, that continues to expand like a wildfire. And once you have realized this, you can enjoy the fruits of the entire cosmos. The entire cosmos belongs to you and you belong to the whole. Such are the secrets as contained in the eternal scripture that God has given to you in the form of love. Unwritten, yet still it is there. Therefore, for the right question and understanding, you have to prepare the soil of your awareness. If you are not in love, or if you have not yet been overwhelmed by the secret of love, then what do you know? What can you know about God? I was thinking, what should I give you today? Because this is the dawn of a new awakening, when love springs forth from its deepest core. What is the way to know this?